Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm doing John 17, and there are a lot of corruption in this one to make the scene pathetic. So people, you know, they become very sympathetic and pathetic, and they can then do whatever they like. Remember how the Pope was killing? And so are the priests in churches. By making the thing pathetic, they fleece you. Sensible people don't go to the church because there is nothing to learn. So Jesus prays for his disciples. Now Jesus never prayed because God our Father is omniscient. So why need to blah blah blah? And also, Jesus had no disciples. Disciple, the John the Baptist, Rabbi and Pharisee and Sadducee, they had disciples. Disciples do what they are told to do. They have no free will. Even if their house catches fire on Sabbath, they are told not to work and they bloody sit down and not put the fire off. It happened couple of times, and a rabbi told me this is quite common, you know. So such are the people which are discipled, and they are blind. We are not blind. We use our common sense, which is Holy Spirit. So here we got John 17 verse 6. I have revealed you to those whom you give me out of the word. That means we know our Father through His Word. So they understood His Word and they saw our Father Christ Jesus, through Christ Jesus. In honor of Christ Jesus we preach. They were yours, you gave them to me. That means they were predestined by our Father. And so Christ Jesus then picked them up and they have obeyed your word. Jesus told them, you know, when the 5,000 after eating the heavenly bread, when Jesus start preaching gospel, that unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you are not part of me. Those people who are men of letters, they took it at the literal meaning. The Jerusalem people, Messianic Jews, mostly they are men of letters. So they all left, you know, this man gone mad, you know, how can we eat him? And those who knew that eating the flesh of Jesus means that what Jesus had uttered through his mouth his flesh, you should understand it. When you have understood it and you have eaten the flesh of Jesus, and when you put that into practice or preach gospel after you have understood, then you have drank the blood of Christ. So blood of Christ is not for everyone unless you are predestined and you are outspoken. You can preach gospel from the rooftops. They were yours, you gave them to me, and they have obeyed your word. Jesus, when they had left, you know, then Jesus asked the 12 laborers, do you want to go also? They said, then Peter replied, where shall we go? That they were given the free will to go. Where shall we go? You have the living bread. Our bread is understanding the gospel. You have the living word of God. Now they know that everything you give, you have given me comes from you. that Jesus stressed this one in Peter. Peter was once born and he did not get gospel. So only once when he got it, when Jesus asked him, Peter, what do you think of me? Then he said, you are the living Christ of living God. Then Christ Jesus stressed to Peter, unless my Father gave you, you can't have it. So the gospel is received by the grace of our Father, because the gospel belongs to him, not to a man. Now they know that everything you have given me comes from you. For I gave them the words you gave me, and they accepted them. So they were preached his word through logical reasoning. When you preach things in through logical reasoning, then there is left no stone unturned. That means you completely, from the very basic principle, you preach them the gospel or make them understand what you are saying. Then there's no argument, you know, that, oh, this I don't understand and that, because you have explained them from the very basic principle. For example, you know, with this turban and beard, you may call me a Sikh, but that is not right. A Sikh means a student of spiritual knowledge. So those who preach gospel, they are also Sikhs. Now, the foot on the earth where I am standing is not of the Sikh, but of my tribal self, Jat. So if you understand this basic thing, that this planet earth belongs to the sons of Adam and not to the Jew, Sikh, Hindu, Muslim, Christian, etc., then you have peace in society. Remember, 2,000 people came to attack our village in Pakistan. My father went out to meet the attacking party headman, and when he explained to him that a Sikh or a Muslim is a spiritual self, not the physical self that is born and die, so we people of Jat tribe are going to die, and you of Rai tribe going to die in this fight. So if there's any enmity between our tribes, let's settle it down now. It's a good chance. He said, no enmity. So all that fanaticism in his head that they are Sikh and we are Muslim was gone, washed away. He came as foe. He returned as our best friend. That's why in the Revelation, Christ Jesus has mentioned those who will be saved, 144,000. They are all mentioned by their tribe, not as Jews. So these present Jews in Israel, they are Jews of physical self. They are unfaithful to Abraham, or they are anti-Semitic tares. So they themselves are anti-Semitic. They call the other people that they are anti-Semitic. So they are being bundled up for final burning. There will be a lot of trouble in the Middle East. Now people, you know, these Egypt and other, now their people are happy, you know, the Western people, some of them, but they don't know that they are going to turn the country into Al-Qaeda, Islamic, you know, and that would be more troublesome than they thought. They have got rid of the moderate Mubarak. Same in other countries, Iraq and Libya, and all these countries will have the fanatic Muslims coming to occupy it. And that will strengthen their forces. But they are who is paying for them? Is the America. who is a Jewish colony, so is the British. They are the colonies of Jews. Mammon or God. Mammon rules in this country and same in America. So, for I gave them the words you gave me, and they accepted them. They knew with certainty that I came from you, and they believed that you sent me. This is a corruption, as in Jesus we do not pray. Now next, you know, Jesus said, I pray for them. And our Father is omniscient. So this is corruption. I pray for them. It's wrong, you know. I'm not praying for the word. That means he is a discriminatory. Our Father is not discriminatory. But for those you have given me, for they are yours. Our Father is not discriminatory. He doesn't discriminate between evil and good. But everybody reaps the reward of his own conscience. If you have evil conscience, you will receive evil reward. You can't blame our Father then. If you have holy conscience, good conscience, you will be reaping the good reward. So it's your conscience that bears fruit. Remember that in this dark age in India, you know, the people's conscience, this dark age in India belongs to people of Khatri tribe. They are very greedy. In this dark age, greed is the dominant. And that's why Christ come to fight against the greed. So there's either greed, mammon, or God. So in India, people of the Khatri tribe, they are very clever. Hello? Ah, kitta? Huh? Main kar dena.